Hello, this tutorial focuses on the different user activity and account activity reports available to you within the user management module here of the Survey Manager. So we're now in the main console of the Survey Manager, and you'll see here in the second shortcut column, user management column, that we have user activity, device activity, and account review. And I'll click on account review. And here we can select the account to work with, and this is a single account, whereas if we had an enterprise account here, you could select from any sub-account that you wanted to run the report on. And we select our from to dates to run the report. I'm just going to grab about a month's worth of data here, and then generate the report. And you'll see in this account activity review, which by the way, it gets sent out by default every 90 days to the account holders, but you can always log in and run an ad hoc report like I've just done. You can also then email it to yourself or print it however you wish. But here's the data, and again, we only have one account and one user in this account. The account is OM Test, the users are PAL, and OM Test, the admin is logged in 146 times in this month and a total of 73 hours and 7 minutes. And the average login time has been 30 minutes. So that's how you can read the user activity section of this report. And you'll see there's three sections in the table. There's survey activity, report activity, and then the top section we've just covered, user activity. So within survey activity, we can see 27 surveys have been created. And then responses, the total response is 953 for an aggregate of different modes or modalities. Since the Survey Manager is a multimodality or multimode system, we have all different methods of distributing surveys. Tablet surveys, 875, mobile phone, these are using our offline survey app, iPod Touch. And of course, tablets and mobile phones can either be Android or iOS, and soon Windows Phone as well. Online surveys, mobile web, etc. So that's the, and then we cover active and inactive surveys as well. In the bottom area, in the last table here, we have reports. So no reports have been saved during this period, but 18 reports have been previewed. And of course, in the Survey Manager, you can run a report, preview it, and then you have the choice of saving it or not. So let's close this account activity report. And now let's go to user activity. This is slightly different. And again, this account only has one user. So if you had more users, they would be appear in this list box. And you just select whichever user you want to run the report on. And you can change your start end dates here. By default, it goes back a year. I'm sorry, 2 years, and I'm going to click Next. And so here in the table, we have a list of login times, starting with most recent. So the most recent is August 9th. This user, RPAO, had been logged in for one minute and did not generate a report at the time. If there was any reports created, this would be a hyperlink in which you could click and then view those reports directly from this report. And then the previous login was August 7th, and they were logged in for a total of 18 minutes. So that's how you can read this particular user activity report. And let's go back to the main console here. And some of the other reports, well, device activity is not necessarily a report. It's an alert that gets emailed to you whenever any of your device types or modes, survey modes, fall beneath a certain threshold that you can set over a time period. So like if I wanted to select a mobile phone and say, hey, I want an alert emailed to me if any of my mobile phones fall below, let's say, a threshold of 100 responses within 15-day period. That would then email me. If I unchecked the email box, then where I can always look for my alerts also is in the main console in this area here, SAT alerts, account activity, device activity. So this is the tab where I would go, and I have none here at this point in time. So you can either check here, or if you had checked the checkbox for email me, then they would just come into your inbox. So this concludes the user activity tutorial, and thank you for your time.